गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस क्लास. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द नोटेशंस ऑफ द एलिप्स. नोटेशंस ऑफ द एलिप्स. नोटेशंस ऑफ द नोटेशंस जस्ट लाइक दैट. एंड फर्स्ट वन एस इक्वल टू x square by a square minus x square by a square plus y square by b square minus 1 equal to 0. And second one, s 1 equal to x 1 by a square plus y 1 by b square minus 1. And third one, s 2 equal to x 2 by a square plus y 2 by b square minus 1. And fourth one, s 1 2 equal to x 2 by a square plus y 2 by b square minus 1. And s 1 1 equal to s 1 1 means x1 whole square, x1 square by a square plus y1 square by b square minus 1. Okay, these are the notations of the ellipse S equal to x square by a square plus y square by b square minus 1 equal to 0. S1 equal to x1 by a square plus y1 by b square minus 1. S2 equal to x2 by a square plus y2 by b square minus 1. S1b equal to x1 x2 by a square plus y1 y2 by b square minus 1. Fifth one, S11 equal to x1 square by a square plus y1 square by b square minus 1. These are the notations of the ellipses, and write down. Now, tangent. A line touches an ellipse exactly at one point is called a tangent. And touching point touching point is called as point of contact. Now this is an ellipse. PX1Y1. It is called point of contact. A line touches an ellipse exactly at one point is called a tangent. Touching point is called as point of contact. This is an ellipse. Okay. This is an ellipse. It is a tangent. Okay, a line touches an ellipse exactly at one point. At one point is called a tangent. Touching point is called a point of contact. This is an ellipse. This is a tangent. This is point of contact. So now write down. Now, normal. Normal. The line. Perpendicular to the tangent and passing through the point of contact that the line which is perpendicular to the tangent and passing through the point of contact is called a normal. Okay, now diagram. this is point of contact. Okay, this is tangent, this is normal, this is point of P, x comma y, point of contact. Point of contact. Okay, the line which is perpendicular to the tangent and passing through the point of contact is called normal. So this is the curve. This is tangent. This line is perpendicular. Perpendicular to the tangent. This is 90 degrees. So passing through the point of contact. This is passing through the point of contact. That is called normal. So the line which is perpendicular to the tangent and passing through the point of contact is called a normal. This is the diagram. This is normal. This is tangent. This is point of contact. Now draw. Here L1 equal to 0 is called a tangent. L2 equal to 0 is called a normal. PX comma y is called a point of contact. Point of contact. L1 equal to 0 is called a tangent. L2 equal to 0 is called a normal. PX comma y is called a point of contact. Okay? Right up. Now, theorem. Write the theorem. The equation of the equation of tangent of the ellipse at x1 y1 is s1 equal to 0. This is the theorem. The equation of tangent of the ellipse at P x1 y1 is at point x1 y1 is s1 equal to 0. And so now we have to draw the diagrams like एक्स वन वाई वन क्यू एक्स टू वाई टू एंड now p x1 y1 here we know that the equation of tangent the equation of secant the equation of secant the equation of secant joining two points joining two points p x1 y1 Q x2 y2 is s1 plus s2 equal to s12 okay the equation of tangent of the ellipse at x1 y1 in s1 equal to 0 these are the two diagonals this is ellipse this is secant secant means the line touches at two points that is called secant So, if secant becomes tangent, secant becomes tangent, like it comes to forward. So, the secant becomes tangent. Again, we know that the equation of secant joining two points p x1 y1 q x2 y2 is s1 plus s2 equal to s12 s1 plus s2 equal to s12 now Now, if secant becomes becomes tangent, then if secant becomes tangent, then S2 equal to S1, S2 equal to S1. We know that S1 plus S2 equal to S12. But we have to write here S2 equal to S1. Then S1 plus S1 equal to S11. We know that S1 plus S2 equal to S12. S1 equal to S12. So we know that S2 is also S1. We have to write like this. We know that S1 plus S2 equal to S12. But S1 right. S2 means S1. Then we have to write S11. We know that Am I right? We know the S1 plus S2 equal to S12. S2 means take S1. Why? Because the secant becomes tangent. S1 plus S1 equal to S11. Now, S1 plus S1, clear. 2S1 equal to S11. S1 plus S1, yes, 2S1. 2S1 equal to S11. And P, X comma, P X comma Y, P X1, Y1, lie on ellipse. If secant becomes tangent, then S2 equal to S1. We know that S1 plus S2 equal to S11. So in the place of S2, we have to write S1. S1 plus S1 equal to S11. 2S1 equal to S11. If P, S1, Y1, lie on ellipse. Then, S11 equal to 0. P, S1, Y1, lie on ellipse. Then S11 equal to 0. Then 2S1 equal to 0. Then S1 equal to 0. We know that S1 means from the notations, X squared by A squared minus Y plus X squared by A squared plus Y squared by B squared minus 1 equal to 0. Sorry. This is S. So now we have to write S1. S1 means X1 by A square plus Y1 by B square minus 1 equal to 0. This is, so first we have to write S. X square by A square plus Y square by B square minus 1 equal to 0. So then we have to write S1. X1 by A square plus Y1 by B square minus 1 equal to 0. Now, this is the theorem. X1 by A square plus Y1 by B square minus 1, this is the proved theorem. Now, we have to take the parametric points of the ellipse. Parametric points. Parametric points. Points. That means X1 equal to A cos theta, Y1 equal to B sin theta. Or the parametric points. Now substitute in that X1 means A cos theta by A square plus Y into B sin theta by B square minus 1 equal to 0. Then A cancelling A one time. That means X by A cos theta plus Y by B. So what we have to then write once. So S1 equal to, take S1 equal to XX1 by A square plus Y1 by B square minus 1 equal to 0. Then substitute parametric points. S1 equal to x. What is x1? A cos theta by a square plus y sin theta y. A sin theta by b square minus 1 equal to 0. S1 equal to a cancelling a. A x by a cos theta plus y by b sin theta minus 1 equal to 0. This is the parametric equation of S1. Or equal to 1. Or equal to 1. X by a cos theta plus y by b sin theta minus 1 equal to 0. Or x by a sin theta plus y by b cos theta equal to 1. Whatever it is. Okay, this is the parametric points. X1 is equal to a cos theta, y1 equal to b sin theta, the parametric points. Okay, students, this is the class of the today. Next concepts learn by tomorrow.